With the new report, the Nevada Department of Health and Human Services released revealing 254 positive COVID-19 tests in state facilities among residents and staff at facilities including assisted living, child care, correctional, behavioral, inpatient, and skilled nursing. Reports from inside corrections seem eerily low. Of the 254 positive cases in state facilities, including 14 deaths, the Department of Corrections is reporting 6 cases, with only 2 of the reported positive tests being inmate cases, one in Ely and one in Casa Grande. If the inside reports are accurate, it may be the most impressive containment of the deadly virus in the world. Or the Nevada Department of Corrections is hiding a reality that will undoubtedly come to light. Regardless, people are trying to get out. During this pandemic, the advocates, allies, and invested partners of those incarcerated and formerly incarcerated have a heightened responsibility to be the voices for family and community members behind the wall. Systems actors have shown the level of empathy that is in place for communities of color. Once thrust into a pandemic, it would be unrealistic to expect different. That is what makes the recent actions of Hope for Prisoners founder and CEO John Ponder disheartening. Ponder landed a spot on the law enforcement heavy Nevada Sentencing Commission in accord with Nevada Revised Statute 176.0133. The commission held a lengthy 5+ hour meeting on April 13th, centered around the unprecedented realities created through the COVID-19 pandemic. During the meeting, as a representative of an organization that works with offenders, as well as those hoping to return to society, Ponder's investment was minimal. From forfeiting opportunities to address the panel to baffling inquiries on the process of inmates entering into prison, Hope for Prisoners seemed poised to provide as minimal hope possible for the thousands of men and women incarcerated through this pandemic. Let's just say, a voting commission member recalled, he was uninterested to say the least. Ponder's most damning action during the lengthy crisis meeting was when voting commission members tallied their thoughts on the potential for freedom for a certain criteria of inmates in custody. The power of the state's pardons board surfaced, and the commission decided it would be beneficial to request the governor to set an emergency meeting with the pardons board. The Nevada Board of Pardons would potentially look into cases of individuals that it has already completed investigations upon and assess the possibilities of expediting these cases. With the voting power to provide a sliver of hope for those a pardon away from freedom, Ponder gave a glimpse of where his allegiance lies. Ponder casted his vote to leave the criteria of inmates hopeless. No, he effortlessly mouthed into his personal computer. Of the 18 casted votes, 10 commission members voted for the emergency meeting versus Ponder and his law enforcement teammates, 8 votes against. The Nevada Department of Corrections, sheriffs, parole, and probation all voted no, as well as Mr. Ponder. During this pandemic, to hold such a powerful vote, a vote that today can mean life or death for someone in custody, Ponder's vote spoke volumes. A man that mere days ago was awarded a partial pardon could effectively vote to leave others without that same hope, tells the real story. Communities of color, please believe every word.